Hello everyone, I am Dr. Shammi Nagpal, Associate Professor, Department of English, Dayanand College, Hisar. Today I am going to talk to you all on Francis Bacon's essay of friendship. But before I start talking about the essay, my very humble suggestion to all of you listening to this video is to listen to as many videos as possible in English. Because I know most of you listening to this video must be students of English literature. But to make it simple and more comprehensible for some of you, I have gone bilingual in this lecture.
The essay was first published in 1612, and then Bacon rewrote the essay and republished it in 1625. He begins the essay by a quote by Aristotle, "Whatsoever is delighted in solitude is either a wild beast or a god." Now, according to Aristotle, whosoever wants to live in solitude cannot be a normal human being. Ya to wo wild beast hoga, ya wo god hoga, saintly hoga. But Bacon does not agree with this statement. Bacon ka ye manna hai ki agar hum society mein rehte hain, to hum solitude mein nahi reh sakte ya hume nahi rehna chahiye. And to prove his point, he has taken certain examples of men who thought themselves to be superior. अपने आप को वो solitude में रखते थे, अकेलेपन में रखते थे, ताकि अपने आप को society से अलग दिखा सकें. और उनमें से कुछ examples जो Bacon ने लिए हैं, Epimendus the Candian, Numa the Roman, Amphidocles the Sicilian and Apollonius of Tyana. Bacon finds the attempt of these men as false. Aur Bacon ka ye manna hai ki ye sirf dikhawa kar rahe hain solitude mein rehne ka. He further tries to prove his point with the help of a Latin saying, Magna civitas, magna solitude, which means great cities are great solitudes. Bacon ka ye kehna hai ki bade shaharon mein log dur dur rehte hain, and since they are scattered, so there is no fellowship. Whereas in smaller cities, since the people stay nearby, they take care of each other in a better way. Ek aur point jo Bacon yahan par friendship ke bare mein kehta hai, उसका ये मानना है कि अक्सर लोगों को जनरल क्राउड और फ्रेंडशिप में फ़र्क ही नहीं पता है. बिकॉज पीपल कुड बी लोनली इवन इन द क्राउड एंड दे कुड फील स्कैटर्ड एंड अनवांटेड इवन इन द क्राउड. इट कुड बी अ गैलरी ऑफ पिक्चर्स वेयर द फेसेस आर ओनली पिक्चर्स और आप एक दूसरे के साथ फ्रेंडशिप नहीं फील कर रहे हैं. Bacon further says that a true friend helps to unload emotional burden. And here he takes the examples of the body. We need the help of certain other things if we have an ailment in the body. And the examples that Bacon has taken is sarza to open the liver, steel to open the spleen, flowers of sulfur for the lungs, castoreum for the brain. Similarly, there is no other way to open the heart except a true friend. So Bacon yahan par hame ye keh raha hai, jis tarah se hame apni sharir ki samasyaon ke liye bahari help leni padti hai, usi tarah se hame ek friend ki help leni padti hai अपने हार्ट को क्योर करने के लिए. देन Bacon takes certain examples from the history and he goes on to say कि हिस्ट्री हमें ये बताती है that everybody needs friends. Even the kings have been in the need of friendship. Since they did not have friends, what they would do most of the times is to raise certain servants or subordinates to a level higher, with whom they could share whatever they felt like. और बेकर ने यहाँ पर एक टर्म यूज़ की है, participes curarum, which means sharers or partners of cares. And the examples that Bacon has taken from history are, the first one is L. Sylla and Pompey the Great. Sylla ने Pompey को एक बहुत important position दी और अपना friend बनाया. But Pompey started feeling even more important than Sylla. और एक बार publicly Pompey ने Sylla को snub कर दिया. And when he was told by Sylla not to do so, he answered back saying that people salute rising sun more than the setting sun. And that was the end of their friendship there. The second example that Bacon has taken from history is that of Julius Caesar and Brutus. Brutus also was raised by Julius Caesar to a level where Caesar put all his trust in Brutus. But Brutus did not act like a friend, and after attaining all the importance from Caesar, Brutus जाकर Caesar के enemies के साथ ही मिल गया और Caesar को मौत के घाट उतार दिया. Another example that Bacon has taken here is of Augustus and Agrippa. When Augustus wanted his daughter to be married, and when he spoke to a counselor, the counselor said, या तो आप अपनी बेटी की शादी Agrippa से कर दीजिए, और अगर Agrippa से नहीं करेंगे, then you have to kill Agrippa. Because with Agrippa living, your daughter cannot marry anybody else. Such became the influence of Agrippa. There are certain other examples also that Bacon has taken. Now here, Bacon wants to tell us that it is not that all these kings did not have families. They did not have power. All these eminent men had access to all pleasures of life. They had families, they had wealth, they had power. But they failed to draw a line in their relationship with their friends, which were the servants who were raised to the level of the friends. Bacon further goes on to talk about the fruits of friendship. By fruits, it means the blessings of friendship or the advantages of friendship. And according to him, the first fruit of friendship is that a man with a friend works two contrary effects. First, it redoubles his joys, and second, it cuts his griefs in halves. Bacon ka ye manna hai ki agar hamara dost hai to uske do fayde hote hain. Agar hum apni khushi uske sath share karte hain to hamari khushi double ho jati hai, aur agar hum apna grief uske sath share karte hain to hamara grief aadha ho jata hai. Bacon feels that it is not necessary that our friend be very intelligent or very knowledgeable. Uska ye manna hai ki jis tarah se sunshine se hamari zindagi mein andhera dur ho jata hai, in the same way our friend can remove all our troubles from our life. He further takes the example of a stone. Bacon ka ye kehna hai ki agar hum apni dukh takleefein एक पत्थर वाले भगवान के सामने भी बैठकर बोलें तो हमारी दुख तकलीफें आधी हो जाती हैं. ही गोज ऑन टू से दैट अ नाइफ और अ ब्लेड कैन बिकम शार्प व्हेन इट इज रब्ड ऑन अ स्टोन. सिमिलरली, इवन इफ अ फ्रेंड डज नॉट नो टू मेनी थिंग्स, ही कैन ऑलवेज हेल्प अस आउट एंड इट कैन बी अ गुड वेंट टू अ फीलिंग्स. एज द फर्स्ट फ्रूट इज फॉर द अफेक्शंस, the second fruit is for understanding of things under different perspectives. According to Bacon, sharing one's problems with a friend is far more fruitful than a day's meditation. A friend's counsel always works. और ऐसे समय में काम करती है एक फ्रेंड की काउंसिल जब किसी को अपने ऊपर डाउट हो रहा होता है या जब कोई अपने थॉट्स को लेकर क्लियर नहीं होता है. ऐसे समय में बेकन का मानना है कि एक फ्रेंड ही हमारी सहायता करके हमें उस सिचुएशन से निकाल सकता है. फ्रेंड एडवाइजेज फ्रीली एंड क्रिटिकली बोथ ऑन अ पर्सनल एंड अ प्रोफेशनल ग्राउंड. एट लास्ट बेकन टॉक्स अबाउट the third fruit of friendship. The first two fruits help for peace in the affections and support of the judgment. And to explain the third fruit, Bacon has taken the example of a pomegranate, which is full of many kernels. यहाँ पर बेकन ने एक अनार का एग्जाम्पल लिया है. उसका ये मानना है कि जिस तरह से अनार में अलग अलग हिस्से बहुत सारे दाने होते हैं, similarly, a friend can also fit into a lot of roles. There are many things which a man cannot do himself. It is at this time that a friend is an appropriate alternative. Because a man owns a single body that can be confined only to a single place. Par agar kisi ka koi friend hoga to wo usko dusri jagah ki bhi jankari de sakega jahan par aapko khud aap nahi pahunch sakte hain. After this, Bacon says that friend can exercise other roles also. A friend can act as a bridge because a man will talk to his child only as a father. Whereas there are certain things that a man cannot talk to his child about aur aise samay mein ek friend ki madad ki zarurat padti hai jo un cheezon ko zyada achhi se explain kar sakta hai. In the end, Bacon says that death is inevitable. A man has to die. And if you have a true friend, your true friend is going to fulfill all your wishes. He is going to take care of all your unfinished work. Ki aapki maut ke baad, jitne aapke kaam bache hain, agar aapka sachcha dost hai, to wo kaam bhi pure ho sakte hain. So in the third fruit of friendship, there are two points that Bacon stresses on. One, a good friend can act as a bridge. Alag alag tarah ke wo role play kar sakta hai. Secondly, a good friend, if loyal or trustworthy, will finish all the works even after your death. But there is something more that Bacon has to say. That advice should not be taken in parts. Because advice taken in parts could be harmful. And here he takes the example of a patient who keeps running to too many doctors. Aap alag alag jagah par itne sare doctors ke paas ja rahe hain, kisi ko aapki puri history pata hai, kisi ko aapki history nahi pata hai, to aise mein us patient ka nuksan ho sakta hai, bajaye ki fayda ho. At the very end of the essay, Bacon closes the essay with a rule. And that rule is, where a man cannot fitly play his own part, if he have not a friend, he may quit the stage. Bacon ka ye manna hai, ki hamari ye jo life hai, that is like a stage. And we all have to play our parts. If we are not a social human being, and if we cannot play our part, then we should quit it. Now that is all about the essay, friends. One thing more that I'd like to share is, for those of you who have to write your exams, I have in particular used the important quotes in all my PPTs. So make sure that you make use of these quotes while writing your answers. Thank you.